Hello, this is Brian, and today we are doing the Beyond Labs lab called 8-3 Identification of Cations in Solution, Silver, Mercury, and Lead. So I've already opened the virtual chem lab. In Beyond Labs, I'm going over here to descriptive chemistry, then identification of cations. Here, this is the one we want, silver, mercury, lead. Opening it up. I'm going to grab a test tube, put it in the metal test tube stand. Notice everything lights up. I don't know if you've done one of these labs before, but also notice if it's just in the test tube rack, this is dark. These are not active options yet, but in the stand they are. And I'm going to grab our ions. Now that they're active, I'm getting silver, mercury. We have two options there, Hg2+ and Hg2+, also known as mercury 1. That's the one we want for this lab, lead. Notice over here on the zoom in screen, it tells us the ions that we just put in there and any other ions or molecules that form while we're doing chemical reactions. And before we proceed, I'm going over here to the divide button. Click that, see a test tube happens here. This duplicates what's in here and here, just in case we want to use it later for, in case we make a mistake. If you haven't done one of these labs before, you might not know these functions and devices down here. There's a centrifuge, you just click on it. You don't have to drag the test tube over. Just click on it and it immediately spins the test tube. A flame or flame test with cobalt glass in the way. This decants off the top if you have a precipitate at the bottom. We already did divide. You just click on this. They call it a heater. We call it a hot plate, and it'll immediately appear before there and immediately heat up your test tube. This puts a pH paper. I'll click on that to show you. See, there's a piece of pH paper that appears over the test tube. This does the same, but it does the vapor, not the solution itself. A nose for sniffing. This is the odor key up here. And this for stirring, pH key up here associated with the pH paper functions. Okay, we're gonna try some qualitative tests. I noticed in the zoom in screen here, we have a nice clear solution. I'm gonna click, see the little, becomes a little dropper, the mouse pointer, and click NaCl. And notice what happened here. There is a change. And you can record your observations. You can also look down here. You can see what happened here. We actually have some precipitates, some insoluble compounds. We can also spin it, centrifuge button, and look what happens here again. Spins down to the bottom, the precipitate is at the bottom, and we have a clear solution above. This is a known solution, so everything shows up here in the window, what's in there. But if this were an unknown solution, we wouldn't see this. We would just see that we'd formed a white cloudy solution, and then we centrifuged it, and we have a precipitate. But we wouldn't know, that could be any precipitate. We wouldn't know which one of these three, or all two or all three, were actually present in the solution. Okay, I'm going to try another test. Notice we have room temperature solution, a precipitate, and clear. I'm going to hit the hot plate. Just click on it, and look what happens here. It's off right now. That means it returns to room temperature right away. I put it on, that changes. Right there, you can see it again. We have the three chloride precipitates. Clicking it on, heating it up. This doesn't look much different, but a little cloudier there. Now we have lead ion free in solution. So when you heat it up, lead becomes soluble again. The heat is still on, notice. I'm going to click centrifuge, spin it, and then I'm going to go over to the decant. So I'm pouring off the supernatant. Notice after I hit decant, a new test tube appeared right here in the rack. And if I mouse over that test tube, you can see up here, take a look up there when it's moused over. We have the supernatant has lead chloride in it. And we still have this one back on the test tube rack. And you can look on the screen again up here on the test tube rack. We've taken the lead out. We still have the other two ions in precipitated form, silver chloride, mercury chloride, but they've been separated. So that's the test for lead. We've demonstrated that we have lead 2 plus ion. Okay, we are going to turn off the heat now. Okay, I'm going to do another test now. Over on the reagent shelf, this is called the reagent shelf, this area right here. I'm going to click on NH3 ammonia. Look up here when I do that. I'm clicking now. Okay, so we have a change. We've got, notice here, the silver ammonia. It's called the diamine silver complex ion, and it is soluble. I'm going to spin it, and so now we have the soluble portion of the solution up here. This green-black solid down at the bottom is the mercury, and I'm going to hit decant again, click that, and notice after a slight delay, we've got our supernatant over here, and as I mouse over it, you can see the silver, diamine silver complex ion is in this solution over here. It added some more water to it, and we just have the precipitate still at the bottom. So that is the test for mercury. We've demonstrated we have mercury there, so we can get rid of this. Just drop it in here. Oh, that didn't work. Has to snap into place there. Now we're going back to our silver. I'm going to grab it from the blue test tube rack, put it back on the stand. You can see it still has the same stuff in it. Now we're going to do another test over here on the reagent rack. I'm going to make it slightly acidic. I'm going to click the pH 4 and check it out. We had a clear solution. Now we have a milky white solution. And this tells us what we've got there. Silver chloride. We could actually go back and forth with this. I could click on the pH 10 here, making it soluble. Back to the pH 4, insoluble, 10, 4. So we've demonstrated the presence of the silver ion, and we're ready to move on to the next step, which is the practice unknown. That's step 7 on your worksheet, by the way. And I believe the worksheet says to click on the unknown. What I'm going to do, it doesn't mention it on the worksheet, but I'm going to clear the lab out, and that should make the unknown ready to go. I'm going to click on it. To make the practice unknown, we're going to click our ions again, silver, mercury 1, lead. Now notice this is an unknown, so it's not over here showing what's in our solution. And on step 7 there on your worksheet, it says to make the minimum 0, the maximum 3. That means your practice unknown can have 0 of none of your ions. In other words, it's just water. It could have a maximum of all 3 of them, or just 2 or 1. And up here, a little hard to find, says create unknown. And right over here, you see, it just appeared there magically. We have a practice unknown. I'm going to drag that over to our working area. See the little label there says practice unknown. Now you could do tests on it like we just did a minute ago. Now to make this active and to be able to do anything, we have to put it in the test tube rack. Still the ions won't show up, the names right there, but we'll still get precipitates and cloudiness, and we can still do the same tests as before. I'm not going to repeat them right now, but you can do that. Now, let's imagine we did a bunch of tests and got results, and we came to conclusions of what we thought was in there. We would then go to the lab book over there, click that, click the report, and check out up here, we have the 3 ions, and we select the ones we think are present. We could select whichever our results came up with. I'm just going to guess here and select all 3. And then once you've got your guesses there, hopefully not just random guesses, click submit. And see, now it gives us results. So apparently in that practice unknown, silver was present. Mercury and lead were not. Got that wrong. So I'm going to return to the lab. I'm going to clear it out. Just clicking on that red bucket clears everything out. And you may not have seen it, but another practice unknown appeared there. Just like before, it's got, remember, anywhere from zero to all three of those ions. And you could do more tests. You can repeat this process many times you want till you feel you've got a grip on how to test for these ions. And each time, you can go over here, do your guess, submit. It'll give you results. Come over here, clear it, and always a new practice unknown will appear there for you to use. So after you finish going through as many rounds of practice unknowns as you want, you're ready for your real unknown, the assigned unknown. So click that to clear out. Click on that clipboard over there. We're going to select basic knowns and unknowns, and the chlorides unknown. That is the one we want. This time, over here, it says unknown number 8. You can see it up here in this area. I'm going to drag this over to the metal test tube stand. Record unknown number 8, and you'll want to give that information to your instructor along with your guess as to what ions are actually present. I think it's a good idea to hit divide. That'll duplicate. You'll have a little reserve here in case you make any mistakes with that. Again, your unknown can have any one or two or three of those ions, silver, mercury, lead, or none of them. So take that into account. Be sure to tell your instructor what you think is in there, as well as your unknown number. Mine says 8 here, yours and your computer will say something different than that, most likely. And that's it.